Hi everyone and welcome back to the Synthax UK YouTube channel. My name's Matt and today I'm going to take you through how you can set up wireless monitoring in your studio or home setup, as well as how you can create a simple single fader monitor controller using RME's TotalMix Remote and an Apple iPad. Now before we get started, make sure that you've already downloaded the free TotalMix Remote app from the App Store, which you'll find linked in the description below. You'll also need to have your RME audio interface connected to your host Mac or PC. Make sure both your iPad and computer are hooked up to the same Wi-Fi network. Now to start, we're going to open TotalMix on the computer and we're going to go to Options and Network Remote Settings. This is also where you'll find some of the information we'll be referring back to occasionally. And first, we're going to select Enable TotalMix Remote Server, which will allow us to control TotalMix remotely from our iPad. So we're just going to leave this open for a minute. So we're just going to hop on over to the iPad. We're going to open the TotalMix Remote app. We're going to click the cog button, which is the settings, and we're going to go to host connection settings. Just up the top here in host connection one, we're just going to put in the IP address as it appears on your host computer. Once you've done that, we're just going to click active, and then we can click OK on the host computer as well. Now you should see your device, in my case Babyface Pro, and the serial number to avoid any confusion. And then what I'm going to do is just press done. Now that we've done that, you can see my headphone level there. You can also see the microphone level. So what we're seeing here is a complete representation of what is being shown on TotalMix on the computer. We now have access to the full mixer window that is on the host computer. So if you're looking for a way to control levels via an iPad, maybe you don't want to be switching between your DAW and TotalMix, then you're good to go. But let's say you want to use the iPad as a personal monitor mixer for an artist. There's still way too much control here, so what we're going to do is create a template that limits TotalMix on the iPad to a single fader so that our performer only has control over the levels they hear in their headphones. So if we go back into the network remote settings on the computer, there is the enable user management setting. So I'm just going to click that. By selecting this, we can now add users and assign them rights. So simply put, this means that each specific user can only access settings which we give them access to. So by clicking add here, you can create a username. You can also add a password as well, but this isn't essential. And then down here is the rights section. Now this is what determines the access that each user has. So you've got the do all, which allows them access to everything. You've got view, which means you can only view things. And then we've got edit submix, which is the option we want. And that means that we can choose a submix to give this user access to. So in this case, we want it to be pH 3 and 4, which is the headphones. And then we're just going to click OK. And we can close this as well. So now back over to the iPad. I'm just going to go on the settings again. In host connection settings, you have the user authentication section. Just going to click that there and then put in our username. So by clicking done, everything here looks exactly the same as it was before. The only difference is if I want to move the headphone level, this is possible. Do whatever I want with the headphone level and anything associated with that submix. But if I was to click this AS1 and 2 here and I change this level, that bounces straight back up to the level set on the host computer. So we're getting closer to a single monitor mixer, but the interface still has a lot going on. So to make it easier for the artist, the final step is to strip back the iPad's interface to leave only the controls we require. So basically, I'm just going to remove everything on the right-hand side of the headphones, and that includes the DAW channel here and the vocal. So we're going to leave those three and get rid of everything else to make this a lot simpler. So back in the settings menu, we're going to go to preferences. And there's this remote behavior sync channel layouts. We're going to deselect this. So what this means is now the iPad and the host computer in terms of layout are running independently of each other. So any changes I make to the layout here will not affect the layout that you see on the host computer. So then we can go to channel layout, and this gives you all the options for the channels that you see in the TotalMix window on the remote. So we're just going to deselect everything that we don't want to see. So we want the DAW channel and the playback channels, and we're going to get rid of the main output and just leave the headphone output. If I click done, there you have it. Everything's been removed but the three channels we want. So we've got the vocal input, the DAW, which would control your backing track or additional instruments, and then the overall headphone level. So there you have it. This is now a single fader monitor mixer that allows any performer, including yourself if you wanted to, control your monitor mix from anywhere in your studio or home setup. We hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you'd like to know how you can achieve something specific with your RME device or in TotalMix FX, let us know in the comments section below and we'll be sure to get back to you. Finally, don't forget to like and subscribe because there's plenty more content coming your way very soon. Thanks very much, guys. See you next time.